So, I just have to be truthful. Sometimes I'm so busy I don't know all the actors and singers and professional people. And my friend, he told me, he said, the reason why we came all the way because we've known Junior husband for a long time. And I will tell you, this last year has been hard on us. And it's been the greatest thing in the whole world. When I came home at night, I knew I was okay. Because he prayed for me every day. He went to ceremony for me every day. And he always had time to say, it's gonna be all right. And I would say, are we doing what's right? He never ever said, don't do it. So when they came to do this video, I think that was the center. Me and my husband only been together a short time, not very long, so I think we're about 32 years now. And we still rely on each other. He is my center. So sometimes people see me and I'm talking with my big mouth all the time. It's only because I have stability at home. I have that foundation.
My relatives, I'm glad to see everybody here, and I greet you with a handshake from my heart to yours. Thank my wife for those kind words. On the other hand, I knew who John Legend was. I have a little bit more time, and I do enjoy music, so I knew who he was. And I seen it as an opportunity. Just like Robert said previously, you know, the community. My concern and why I back my wife 100% is Minnie Wachoni. Minnie Wachoni, Water of Life, is important, very important, because our lives depend upon it. We do not exist without water. And I've seen this initially and still yet as a threat. Our water system in the community of Cannonball, which will be when that pipeline leaks. The first tragedy will be the community of Cannonball, where my wife grew up, where many of her relatives reside, where a lot of people we love live. So we took this upon ourselves, and I'm proud of her for what she done to fight for our treaty rights. Our human rights, all the injustices that were done to us as Native people, as Indigenous people, and as people throughout the whole world. It wasn't just us we were thinking about. We were thinking about five generations to come, and all the people downriver, millions, that would suffer. So these are things that we took upon ourselves to help our community in any way we could, to provide media coverage. I've seen this opportunity as soul. So, loving my wife the way I do, and caring about her, caring about all our people, I supported her 100% and still do. We're still, this movement is still alive. Matakiapi, we're still out there, we're still fighting, we're not going to stop. So, once again, we need to stand up. Minnie Wachoni. Thank you.
All right. Yes, stay on up here. If we can have LaDonna go and stand up here. Good presentation. Let's give him a round of applause. Let me hear you. Let me hear you. Also, let's give my brother Robert Upham a round of applause. Let me hear you. Good one. Good one. At this time, let's stand on the light. Your husband has a really cool voice. He needs to do voiceovers out in LA. Give him a round of applause. I'm gonna have you call my wife when I'm on the road and just say, you know, your husband said he loves you and he misses you. At this time, I'd like to call upon Phyllis Young to come on up here on behalf of the Standard Rock Reservation. I'm going to turn this portion of the program over to you and let you kind of do so. So let's welcome Phyllis Young, ladies and gentlemen. Hello.
Thank you. I can't stop smiling. I love this lady. In the early days when she opened the Sacred Stone Camp, she was hustling from the community and making soup for those first people that were there from their own community. And to go into that place on April 1st, I thought that when I look back and there were horseback riders, there were kids on bikes, there were people walking, and there were about 150 cars of our own families from Standing Rock going into Sacred Stone. And LaDaNa was leading the path. And when I look back, I got really emotional because I thought back to 40 years ago. It's a legacy that was left to her and a responsibility by her family, because it was her maternal aunt, her dad's sister, Annie Thunderhawk, who called upon the American Indian Movement to come to Cannonball. In those days that we were defying government policies on our spirituality, the American Indian Movement came in 17 cars at Annie's request. And when you think about it, back to that day, that request was very simple. But she had to bring in the American Indian Movement too, led by my brother Russell Means, to pray Wachekia in that way, in our language. She wanted a pipe ceremony. We didn't grow up strong spiritual people in our Lakota Ochetishakoe tradition. It was banned from 1910 to 1978. So we grew up colonized and Christianized. So for this lady, this Ochi, this tough grandma, because that's what she was. And when she said she was bringing the American Indian Movement, she was catching heck from her community. Well, it's going to be full of trash. I got a lot of boys, grandsons. They'll clean it up. Well, what are we going to feed them? I got a lot of daughters and granddaughters. We'll feed them. So she had all her answers for American Indian Movement to come in 40 years ago. All she wanted was a pipe ceremony. All she wanted was a language speaker to pray in our language. So it's been a long haul, it's been a long struggle as we pass from our infancy to our adolescence and to becoming full adults with our own spirituality. And so the legacy is a beautiful one at Cannonball. And that's who LaDaNa comes from her family. And she stepped up, and she wasn't afraid. But she didn't show fear, she just showed her human side, her compassion. So in those early days, when I looked back and I saw our people coming, our children, our grandchildren, what our community wanted. She acknowledged the sacred stones and the effigies that are there and the lessons for the next generation. So she's a beautiful lady. She's our new ambassador. She's going meeting for Paris tomorrow, so we wanted to do this. And this film festival is very small. Our numbers are small. So if there's 10 people in a meeting, but very meaningful, we can do things. We've proved that in the past. So as she goes as our ambassador to the world, and we know we have to have good ambassadors who understand our protocol. So this is our film festival. It's a beginning, a very small beginning for the continuing stories of our way of life. Our way of life. We're going to show the world. We have a lot to offer. We come from an egalitarian society, a universal one, pluralistic, encompassing all. So we're prepared to do that as grandmothers, and I'm very proud of her. Very beautiful lady inside and out. And she prevailed, and she had to put up with a lot. She lost her job, but remember, jobs are part of conformity and confinement. And the bondage and slavery that we talk about, that is indentured America. We are not that. We are free. So I want to honor her with this medallion. Very special gifts. I have one. I'm very proud of it. I love it. And for LaDaNa, she earned it. She deserves it. And so I want to present her with this on behalf of Ocheti Shatoi for water, for the water protectors. Special gifts that were made for us. So I want to give this to LaDaNa.
Film or close it? Should I close the film or not?